Welcome to the Hyperview DCIM demo video recording. On the screen now is the Hyperview application. This is a demonstration Hyperview instance populated with assets of all shapes, sizes, and types. On the left-hand side of the screen, you will see the Hyperview main menu options. This is where you can navigate to all of Hyperview's core features, such as asset management, connectivity, discoveries, product catalog, and more. Under the Asset Management feature, you have access to several navigation options. The first option is a standard asset hierarchy, which allows you to group your assets based on physical or logical location. Another option is a more visual perspective. Each location has the ability to house a layout specifically tailored to that group. There are two types of visual location layout. The first location layout is the map view. The map layout is populated from the address property values associated to child locations and is integrated with Google Maps to provide you with an interactive top-down view of your sites. By default, the map view offers you a status overview of each site as well as serves as a navigation function. The second location layout is the floor plan. The floor plan layout mode allows users to build a custom floor plan for each site using the built-in layout editor. Use custom background images, set room dimensions and grids, and place assets onto the floor plan using simple drag and drop features. The floor plan layout mode offers many different view filters to quickly obtain information on your infrastructure at a glance. It also allows users to tie environmental sensor data to the layout to generate heat maps for the room. Along with the 2D visualization of the environment, Hyperview also provides a 3D representation. The 3D view is automatically created based on the positions of the assets and the model properties associated to those assets, so no extra effort is required for setup. It offers the same context options as the 2D view, but also provides insights to each individual asset inside the racks. You can identify where those assets are located, the health of those devices, as well as the environmental details, all within a single interactive view. Navigating into a rack, you can see that you are greeted with an asset dashboard. Each dashboard in Hyperview contains a collection of widgets populated with live sensor information from those assets. You can customize each dashboard so that the information that is most important to you is readily available each time you visit that asset. The layout view for racks allows you to identify all of the contained assets within that rack. This includes rack-mounted assets in a visual front and rear rack elevation, 0U and unplaced assets such as vertical rack PDUs, and even assets on a shelf within the rack. Individual assets contain many different types of data and information about that device. Most of this information can be found in the information menu options, which include details like properties, components, sensors, and more. The Properties page provides a snapshot of the latest asset information such as model specifications, power settings, and other general details. This information can come from many different sources such as auto discovery, user-entered data, or the application itself, each of which are outlined in the source column of the Properties page. The Sensors page contains a list of sensor readings from or about the asset. Sensors are typically auto-discovered and can be enabled for continuous monitoring to keep the asset up to date. They come in two main types. The first sensor type is a direct sensor, which is read directly from the asset itself via various discovery protocols. The second is a calculated sensor, which are not read from the device, but rather generated automatically by Hyperview based on the direct sensor readings. Different asset types will house different interaction options for you to view. For example, a server type asset will contain more component information than a rack PDU. the components page will outline the hardware specifications that were automatically discovered from that unit. Network devices, on the other hand, will have information more catered towards network connectivity under the Network Components page. This page provides automatically discovered data about the network interfaces and the port schedules. Now that we have an idea about what types of data can be collected, stored, and managed in Hyperview, let's review how that information is populated. The first method of populating assets is manual. Users have the option to add individual assets through the Add New menu, which can be used to create single devices by following the simple Add New form. Users also have the option to use the built-in bulk import tool to generate entire asset libraries from a spreadsheet file. Simply download the template file from Hyperview, insert the data you wish to import, and then run the import tool. Hyperview will run checks on the data to validate any potential errors and then create the assets in bulk. The second method of creating assets is the most powerful function of Hyperview, the auto-discovery feature. While on its surface, discovery tools may seem daunting, but Hyperview simplifies the workflow to be easy to understand and simple to use. In order to start the discovery process, you will first need a Hyperview data collector. You can download the data collector from the user interface. Options for a Windows, Linux, or Raspberry Pi version is available. Once downloaded, installed, and registered, you're ready to perform discoveries. Auto discovery setup contains three main parts. First, create a new discovery and provide the basic settings like a name for that discovery, which data collector to use, and where Hyperview should create the assets. Next, you will outline the IP ranges for the discovery to scan. These can be input by CIDR range, list, specific range, or even specific address. Finally, you need to provide the access credentials for the data collector to authenticate with the target assets. Once complete, you can run the discovery and start seeing results immediately. Now that Hyperview is discovering and monitoring assets, it can start to generate additional advanced features such as alerting and notifications. The data collector has a built-in SNMP trap listener service, which handles any notification sent directly from the asset. It also has a built-in threshold manager, which allows you to define an asset's sensor parameters to automatically trigger warning or critical alarms. Each device has an events page where you can view and manage the status history for that asset. Notifications for these status messages can also be sent via email if you have the watching feature enabled for that asset. Driving decisions based on information collected from your assets can be difficult to manage, so Hyperview has a built-in advanced search engine which contains virtually all asset information for you to leverage. The advanced search uses predefined and custom filters to allow users access into advanced custom reporting techniques. Identifying capacity based on asset load, rack space management requirements, environmental overhead, power consumption versus provisioning, and more, all of which are comprised of live asset data from discovery and monitoring, can be accomplished in just a few clicks using advanced search. Finally, everything that was covered in this demonstration is also available via API endpoints. Hyperview is designed with an API-first methodology, which enables smooth integration methods with other tools. The Swagger API documentation allows you to view and interact with each endpoint to meet all of your DCIM needs.